I don't know what caused my root canal situation.
Well, British people have notoriously bad teeth, so...
I've never heard that.
Really? You've never heard people make jokes about British teeth?
None of the Brits I know have a situation with their teeth.
Well, it's just a thing people say.
Like when they say older women have bread back.
What's bread back?
The loaf of back fat between a woman's bra and her giant underwear.
No, that's not a thing. People don't say that.
Not to you, no.
I think we're getting off on the wrong foot here.
It's turned into a bit of a situation.
You use that word too much.
So any siblings?
After IKEA tomorrow, you want to go see Margaret Cho at the Beacon?
Oh, boy. Oprah?
Yes, Gail?
I think we need to take a break.
Is this because I wanted to submit us for the Amazing Race? Because I was 80% joking about that.
You know, I said I'm not into chasing straight girls. And I kind of think that's what's starting to happen here. So, unless you're ready to make a big life change, I need to move on. Find my Stedman.
I thought I was Oprah in this metaphor. Also, you're gay, so that's a little confusing. You should say, like, my lady Stedman.
Okay, I'm going out on a limb here.
Okay, sorry. It's just, if I try to imagine us being together, I think, yeah, okay, this could be fun, you know, picking out furniture and making flower beds out of old railroad ties. But the thing is, if I'm gonna be with someone, it has to be a guy.
You sound pretty sure about that.
What can I say? I love a bald spot and a hairy back.
You're alone there.
Oh, my, my, what a pleasant surprise. Lemon. And you brought a man, Jack Donaghy. And this is my friend Anastasia.
How are you?
Hi, Dennis Duffy, Beeper King.
The Beeper King, really?
Dennis has his own business. Yes, he's an entrepreneur. He's very successful.
You probably see my ads on the 7 train, right?
I didn't know they served chicken nuggets at this restaurant.
It's cod. It's, they made it special. Dennis had some dietary restrictions.
Actually, I'm allergic to all fish, unless it's fried, you know?
That's a sharp tie you've got there, Dennis.
A douchebag up front, anywhere.
Does he know you're the Beeper King?
I don't think so.
Anyway, thanks for the hookup. This is clearly the nicest restaurant we've ever been to.
Well, hold on a second. This place ain't that nice, right?
It's got rats and roaches like every other restaurant.
No rat talk tonight, okay?
You know there are 17 rats per person in Manhattan? You eat a pound of rat crap every year without even knowing it, huh?
I think I read about that in the New Yorker. Anyway, we'll leave you to your meal. I hope you enjoy the choices that you've made.
So you like the music?
Yeah, speaking of music I like, how about Gnarls Barkley, huh? That guy's great. Have you been to his official website? It's really... Oh, God, is it only 1 a.m.?
Yeah, so after this, I figure we hit up Marquee. They only serve drinks till 4, but I can get us into this great after-hours club in Brooklyn.
I'm 37.
What?
I'm 37. Please don't make me go to Brooklyn.
I'm 20.
Oh, boy. This just went from a senior dating a freshman to Mary Kay Letourneau and Vili Fulau.
Are those friends of yours, or...?
No way. Your elevator opens right into your apartment?
Are you coming in?
I don't know. This is new for me. I don't really hang out with superfluously handsome gentlemen in kick-ass elevator lofts.
What else don't you do?
I don't smoke. I don't use any drugs except for my allergy medicine. I don't download music without paying for it. And I never wear flip-flops, ever. It's gross. Yeah, that's real.
I do not sit on laps.
Really?
Nope, not a lap sitter. Never have been.
Nice to see you again.
I thought you were trying new things.
Okay. Just a small girl thing. It's not a grown lady thing. Okay. All right, here we go.
Okay. Mm-hmm. See? It's not so bad.
No, it's not bad. I keep waiting for something to go wrong.
Thanks for coming out. I know my situation is complicated, but I really enjoyed your company the other night.
I had a great time, too. So, with your agoraphobia, how does this work?
Well, it's not easy. We can never leave the house. and would just probably sit around all weekend and watch TV.
Go on.
There's not much else to do up here but eat and read celebrity gossip on the internet and nap the day away.
Really?
And unfortunately, because of my phobias, we could never be physically intimate. I know. What woman would want all that?
So, thanks for dinner. You sure know a lot about sushi.
No, you gotta be careful. They try to upsell you to real crab.
So we...
Listen, I gotta get going. I got a lot of work tomorrow.
All right, listen, we're both adults here. We know the deal. Let's cut to the chase.
That's certainly direct.
We go upstairs, 20 minutes, open mouth, I will work your ears.
I don't know, Liz, what you're asking me to do is a big deal. If I go through with this, I need to know it's worth it.
Fine, 30 minutes, I'll make some sounds, and you can say one weird thing to me. All right, hardball, 30 minutes, sounds, top front of my body is now in play. Deal?
Deal.
Hi, you must be Kevin.
No, let me finish.
Are you? He's my dad. It's take your daughter to work day, which I object to on feminist grounds.
It's patronizing, like girls don't know what jobs are. I'm Liz, by the way.
I'm Catherine, but everyone calls me Cat, although I'm trying to get people at school to call me Scout, like in To Kill a Mockingbird.
I love that book. I had my first crush on a shop teacher who looked just like Boo Radley.
Yeah, Scout's not getting much traction, though.
Well, it's hard to force a nickname. I tried to get my high school tennis team to call me Ace, but they wanted to call me Shorts Accident. So we settled on Super Virgin.
Okay, so I might not get Scout, but I can negotiate up from Puked and Thermos.
Well, then let me ask you this. Would Jeremy Lin be willing to videotape a message for my buddy's bachelor party? Oh, sorry, she's with me. It's... Take your daughter to work day, and Cable Town's really into all this family shiz.
So what have you learned today?
That people who talk the most in meetings often know the least.
She sat in two meetings with me. I crushed it. So what's your deal? You ski?
I don't. You know, if I'm gonna fall down a hill and die, I wanna do it for free.
B. Ryan, what is up, Slick?
Do you think I could pull off a haircut like Scout had in the movie?
I've been there, Kat, and you should know that people are gonna assume that
I'm a lesbian. I know. I just needed to hear it.
I should go. I'll see you around.
Okay, wait, what if we made a pact? What if we say that in like 25 years, if neither of us has someone, we'll move in together and be roommates? And even though I am not into the sex stuff, if it helps you, I would let you do stuff to me.
I can't be around you anymore. Bye, Liz.
That's funny, that's what the guys always say. Who's gonna go with me to cooking class next weekend?
Well, if by cooking class you mean your bed, and by next weekend you mean tonight.
Shut up. I can see your wedding ring. Idiot.
Look at us. We look awesome together.
Yeah, now I know why Demi Moore does this.
All right, Mom. I'm taking off.
Mom?
Yeah, I'm 20. I can't afford this place.
All right, honey.
Have a good time. Oh, hi. I'm Beth.
Why do you have a picture of my great aunt Dolly?
No, that's my grandmother's cousin, Dolly.
Dolly Harlan. No, I said Dolly Harlan. Harlan. From Smithtown.
Oh my God, we're related. Oh no, oh wow. God. Wow. This is the worst!
Franklin and Eleanor Roosevelt were fifth cousins.
Okay, on the count of three, say what level of cousins we would have to be for this to be okay. One, two, three.
Fifth.
Unacceptable, no matter what.
This is never gonna work.
Of course it's not. It never was. This is what I get for trying to be somebody I am not.
Whoa, 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 whoa! Look. I meant what I said earlier. You are a hairless lemon. It's in our blood. Accept it. Embrace it. I think we're third cousins.
Yeah, I'll see you at the reunion. Well, I should go.
Do you have everything? Do you have your cell phone?
Oh. Nerds, where is it?
There it is in the other room. Carl, could you get Liz's cell phone for her so I can say a proper goodbye? Thanks, buddy. Anyway, I just...
We don't have much time, Liz.
Look, Liz, I've decided I can trust you, so I'm going to tell you the truth. I'm not really an eccentric agoraphobe. I just tell people that so they won't know I'm under house arrest for tax fraud and arson.
The wind must have blown it shut, Carl. I'm searching for the key.
Carl's a U.S. Marshal.
Come, before they shoot!
I thought Derek was upstairs. I miscounted the men, Liz. I miscounted the men.
Why are you still messing with my show? What about last night?
Liz, last night was what it was, but business is business.
Right, and last night I gave you the business. We had an agreement. Top front and some light ear work. You got your quid holster? Where's my quo?
Oh, my God. Last night was about the show?
Oh, please. You know it was. You were all, oh, it's gotta be worth it, and what you're asking me to do is such a big deal.
It was a big deal, being with a woman for the first time since my wife died.
Oh, snap.
It was just a transaction? What kind of person are you?
Does it help if I tell you I thought we were doing sexual espionage?
Oh, God! Sharon! Angel! I swore to you the next one would be worthy, but she's not! She's a miser! And Dr. Walters in my sketch.
This guy makes badushas. They're like an Indian donut. They're amazing. Mucheado badusha jahir.
Careful, buddy. It's hot.
Are you trying to pick me up to keep me from touching fire?
Kiss me.
Wait a minute. When you first met me, did you think I was a child?
Yes, I did, sir.
Unbelievable. I knew I should have listened to my friends. Kofi said you were too good to be true. Nah. Huh? Told me to wait 3 days before I called you. And yet, here we are. Is anything even going to happen between us tonight?
No. But not because of your size. It's because I have a thing about intimacy. I'm the weird one. I'm weirder than you.
How am I weird?
You're not. That came out wrong.
You came out wrong. Oh, and I lied about your show. I have seen it.
Be careful crossing the...